Okay, hello again. We are going to start with the second talk of this session. I will introduce Silvia Franceschi. Here she is. Silvia is a Master in Science in Environmental Engineering, Master in Project Management and PhD in Mountain Environment and Agriculture, specialized in hydrology, geomorphology, and hydraulics. She develops and applies environment models for engineering projects, in particular related with natural hazards and the maintenance of natural resources. She will be delivering the extraction of hierarchical and homogeneous structure of subbasins from a given area with HortonMachine GeoFrameInputBuilder. So I'll share your screen, and the floor is yours.
Thank you. Thank you to Jorge, and thank you to all attending the presentation. I'm here to present you some of the tools that we developed in the Horton Machine Library to aggregate, to do a geomorphological analysis on the basins and aggregate sub-basins at different aggregation scale. So, first of all, who am I? Jorge already introduced me, but I am also I am an environmental engineer specialized in hydrology, hydraulic, and geomorphology. But I'm also a co-founder of Hydrologies, which is a very small Italian engineering company placed in the northern Italy. We develop open source tools for environmental engineering. And one of these tools is the HortonMachine Library. So what is the HortonMachine Library? The HortonMachine Library is basically an open source geospatial library focused on hydrogeomorphological analysis and environmental modeling. It is available as a suite of standalone application, and its development started from 2002 at the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering of the University of Trento. This is a short roadmap of the development of the library. As you can see, we have a very close relation with the research departments, and in particular the University of Trento and the University of Bolzano. And in the last year, we started also a collaboration a support collaboration with the Basque Center for Meteorological Climate to implement and use some of our tools in their system. So the HortonMachine suite provides tools to analyze different environmental processes. For example, extreme flood, debris flow, large wood floods, shallow landslides, vegetation and forestry analysis, meteorological data interpolation, and in general, geomorphological related analysis and elaboration of geomorphological related processes. But we do much more than processes. We do also modeling, and in the HortonMachine Library, there are models to design and verify aqueducts and other urban networks, like as drainage waterfall for rainfall and so on. Then we have an application for digital field mapping, and we have tools and application for handling geospatial data, like spatial database, raster and some vector data, and a complete geoscripting environment. The HortonMachine suite is provided as a zip archive, which contains all the dependencies for all the operating systems. So you do not need anything else, just to download the folder and unzip the folder for Windows, Linux, and iOS. And inside you can find a set of applications for environmental and geospatial processes. For example, you can find the database viewer with which you can connect to online and local databases, the GeoPaparazzi and the Smash Project Viewer, which allows you to visualize directly, easily visualize projects taken from our mobile applications for digital field mapping, GeoPaparazzi and Smash. There is the scripting console containing also tools for doing complex analysis with scripting, but also tools for visualizing and analyzing rasters and vector data. Then there is other tools to connect and prepare the data for the mobile application. For example, the GForm, which allows you to prepare the forms to take notes with forms, complex notes in our mobile application. The MapCalc to do complex elaboration calculus on raster maps. And two tools to quickly visualize data. The quick folder to visualize local data, rasters and vectors, and the WMS to GeoTIFF creation, which allows you to connect to a WMS and download a TIFF with the extension of the area of interest. Another interesting tool is the SLD creator, which is a tool to create the SLD style file specification for a raster or a vector data, which can be used in some GIS application to visualize the style as you defined in a previous moment. And also it is used also in our mobile applications. And then there is the core of the HortonMachine library, which is the Spatial Toolbox. The Spatial Toolbox gives you the access to all hydrological and geomorphological models. And it is composed of a graphical interface. On the left side, you have the models list. And if you select a model, on the right side, you will see the parameter list. Then there are some options that can be set, like to see or not the experimental modules, to run in the bug mode if you have some problems, or even if you want just some more verbose output. And to allow the amount of allowed process memory. That this depends on the data you want to analyze. And then on the top right of the graphical interface, you can find the running options. You can run what you see in the script, or you can run an external script, or create a script with what you have in the console to run then what you have in the toolbox to then run in the console, for example, and visualize the data in a quick map. The models in the left side are grouped in different categories. The main category, the original category, is the HortonMachine category, which contains tools for geomorphology analysis. Then there are the categories for analysis of rasters and vectors. And then mobile tools to support the connection between the mobile applications for digital field mapping, Smash and GeoPaparazzi. The Lesto tool, which contains a lot of tools to analyze LiDAR data, high resolution LiDAR data for forest analysis. And the PIDAL and GDAL direct connection to some of complex commands run inside the HortonMachine. The main purpose of the HortonMachine at the beginning was the hydrogeomorphological analysis. We have a set of tools for the evaluation, for example, of the hydrological cycle, and in particular, the maximum discharge. following for a real past event or for extreme precipitation evaluated through their a statistic of rainfall. There are tools for geomorphology tools to extract topographic parameters from the digital terrain model, and other minor hydrogeomorphological tools to evaluate other kind of variables of the basins. Then it is possible in the console to evaluate some statistical complex statistical analysis with the scripting, and for example evaluate the parameters of the rainfall intensity curve. And then there is the real model to apply, which is called peak flow, and it is a semi-distributed hydrological model based on the geographic instantaneity unit hydrograph. And it works evaluating the maximum discharge for the period or for the event, the hydrographic unit hydrograph is evaluated using the width function. The precipitations are considered constant, and there is a separation between superficial and subsuperficial flow. This is an example, the evaluation of the maximum discharge for the event, the evaluation of the complete for an event, there is the evaluation of the discharge, the response of that event. And if you insert a statistical precipitation, you have the evaluation of the maximum discharge for that statistical inserted. Then we have tools to evaluate debris flow, and in particular to evaluate the probability of starting a debris flow from the network and from the hill slopes, and the definition of the hazard maps on the alluvial fans. Shallow landslides are also supported in the Horton machine following the stability model of Montgomery and Dietrich Shallstab based on the theory of the infinite slope. And the output of this model are the maps of critical precipitation in each pixel and the map of stability for the given precipitation for each pixel. Then we have another very important hazard phenomena in the Alps in particular, which are large wood floods. And we developed also a GIS-based method to evaluate the amount of large woods during a flood, considering the recruitment from the bank erosion and from the hill slopes and the transportation along the network. And for each section, for example, the contribution from bank erosion and hill slopes is evaluated. And then there is an hydraulic propagation model, which propagates the flow and also the wood when possible to downstream through the sections. And considering the dimension and the amount of the wood and of the section, the sections are considered critical or not. Since we have a very hard collaboration with the University of Trento, which is the team for the development of the GeoFrame hydrologic system, we decided also to make this bridge between the Horton machine and GeoFrame a bit more visible. So what is GeoFrame? GeoFrame is a complex system for doing hydrology analysis by computer. It is based on OMS-3 infrastructure, which is developed by USDA and Colorado State University. And it is a system composed of more than 50 models components, which perform single tasks, so you can personalize which of the models you want for your particular case study and build a modeling simulation. Then the final purpose of this system is in any case to simulate the complete hydrological cycle within a watershed. Some of the components of GeoFrame are meteorological data interpolation, terrain analysis, in connection, in direct connection with a bridge with the code of the Horton machine, calibration, rainfall runoff model, runoff propagation along the network, evaporation and transpiration, snow model, infiltration, and freezing model for snow. The Horton machine is used, as I anticipated, in the GeoFrame as a support tool to prepare input based on hydrogeomorphological operations. So in the Horton machine, there is the definition of the structure of the network. In particular, there is the definition of the structure of the network and the identification of the hydrological units. And then we added and also the possibility to split the network in other point of interest and extract basin for those particular point of interest, which can be artificial intakes or outtakes or other monitoring points. Now we introduced other two tools. One is for the aggregation of the hydrological units into homogeneous subbasins. And then another one to create the complete structure of the input of the GeoFrame system directly within the Horton machine, and considering also the lakes, natural or artificial areas of lakes. This is an more or less the schema. In the Horton machine, it is possible to do DTM analysis from the pitting flow direction extraction of the network, and then the identification of the hydrologic response units, the very basic units, and then the aggregation of those units in homogeneous basins. This aggregation of the units in homogeneous basins will be done with the net numbering tool. The net numbering tool is a tool that was originally in the Horton machine, and it is needed. It is used to give an enumeration of the network. But we added two more inputs, which are the desired area of the aggregated basins and the tolerance on the area of these basins to be used, because it is not so easy to cut the basin exactly at those at the desired area. And then we have some output. The output is the ordinary output, the numbered basins and network. And then the new desired aggregation and the graphical schema in UML of the original and desired aggregation. And then together with the topology file and some text info file. This is an example of the hydrological units, originally hydrological unit, and this is that the units aggregated at 50 square kilometers of the area desired. This is the UML schema of the original subbasins, and this is the aggregation at 10 square kilometers, and this is the aggregation at 50 square kilometers. Then we have the other tool, which is the tool for GeoFrame Inputs Builder, which is the tool to create the folder with all the data needed by the GeoFrame system to run. It is there are mandatory inputs that are all created in the Horton machine, and optional inputs for and the output is the folder of the data. The inputs are mainly hydrogeomorphological analysis and those the map of subbasins calculated with the net numbering. And then the other inputs are the possible inputs for lakes are the shapefile of lakes, the original topology, because we have to insert lakes, so we have to modify the original topology, and the parameters to evaluate the length of the network inside the basins. The output is a folder with a subfolder for each subbasin, and a shapefile, two shapefile for all the basin. In case of vectors, you have to provide the data of vectors. There are some restrictions in case of lakes, some restriction on the polygon of lakes to be handled in the command. And the result is this. This is the original subdivision of the basin. These are the lakes. And as you can see, the lakes are inserted directly in the structure, and also the network is cut in the structure. So this is almost what we have in our HortonMachine library. If you need something or if you have some questions, just let me know.
Thank you, Silvia. You did it just now in time. Perfect. Thank you very much. There are no questions from the audience, but I have a couple of them. One is technical and the other one not that much. You mentioned that you have scripting or a console. Yeah. Is that like a regular language, like Python or Groovy?
Groovy, exactly. Groovy mm-hmm. and JavaScript inside the console.
So can it be then the HortonMachine integrated with other like data pipelines?
Yes, HortonMachine has a way for running through a command line. So mm-hmm. if you need the complete command, you have to ask, and then we give you the possibility to access to the, mm-hmm. the way to access to this kind of command.
Okay. And the other question was, looking at the very beginning of of your slides on the history of the project, there were mentionings of you first integrated with GRASS or worked with GRASS, then Judith. How was the path of, I understand, moving away from other desktop GIS tools into yes. your own data graphical user interface and all the pieces?
No, we do not have any graphical interface. We just have this quick viewer, but it is not a GIS. We mm-hmm. We decided to do a thing like that because to be too much connected to a GIS, it was meaning forcing the users to use that GIS. And since mm-hmm. most of the users use QGIS, and we have some problem to connect Java, which is the language of our tools, to QGIS, so we decided that even the users of QGIS can use and are welcome to use our tools. So we prefer to have nothing in connection with other GIS and simply drag and drop the files inside the graphical interface and visualize on your preferred GIS.
Mm-hmm. That was exactly a question that came while we were talking about any chance or possibility to integrate some of those tools into QGIS or some Python workflow. I understand that calling the operating system, you can just run your processes integrated with pipelines in other desktop GIS. So you remain kind of independent or integrated, yeah. be able to be integrated with other tools.
If you want to do something, you are dependent on the operating system. So you have mm-hmm. to do at least three version of the things and maintain all, and we are very small. So mm-hmm. we prefer, if there is an easy way to share these things, we are very welcome to do that. But mm-hmm. Now we didn't find it yet, but we...
Oh, it broke a little bit for the last time, at least for me. Okay. Don't worry. We don't have any other questions. So any closing remarks or anything that you want to mention?
No, I think just I wanted just to add one thing. I show you here a possibility to personalize a module of the HortonMachine for a specific application system, which is GeoFrame. But we are open also to integrate models for other hydrological or morphological or geological models. So to prepare the data for models based on digital terrain model, data interpolation, and something like that, the HortonMachine is a very useful tool.
Okay, I'm sure that people will reach you if they have interest in integrating with you. Okay, thank you very much, Silvia. Nice talk. So now we have 4 minutes for the next talk with Guido. So see you in 4 minutes.